Cool.
I have to have the milk with the cookies.
You go right ahead.
Retirement.
You're in my way.
I'm sorry.
Back up.
Mixes right in.
Those are my rosemary honey. What do you think?
With the Korbas.
They're pretty good.
Who recently moved from Maryland to the new Lake Margaret section of the Highlands in Chesterfield.
Is there an on and off switch that I can just flick them if I want them on?
No.
Early in the, no.
The couple loves their new home and lifestyle, but there's one problem.
And I look in my mailbox and I see nothing, and it's been that way for over 3 months now.
Kenneth Korba has a Postmaster General approved U.S. mailbox. And yet, by our clock, he has to drive over 8 minutes each way to the post office to pick up his mail.
I mean, I want to get my mail here at my home.
Even more exasperating, Korba says, sometimes when he goes to pick the mail up, he's told it's out with a carrier on a delivery route that runs through the Highlands, bringing it within 1.5 minutes of his home, yet it won't be delivered.
It's a little frustrating knowing that a quarter of a mile away over in the Highlands and over in Lake Margaret, they're delivering the mail.
Why? Because of a cost-saving decision made by the USPS in 2012 to require new subdivisions to have something called cluster mailboxes, where all the mailboxes are together in one spot. Yet local developers and builders say the new policy was not adequately communicated by USPS, so they didn't plan for cluster mailboxes.
I was aware that the post office at one time had said that they would no longer do individual mailboxes. But specific to Lake Margaret, no, I was not. We thought that we would have normal mail delivery to individual boxes.
Tricia Smith with Shell Brothers, the company that built the Korba home, says USPS never consistently enforced the rule. So some of their new homes get mail, but the Lake Margaret buildings don't. And now it's too late for cluster mailboxes to be added.
At this point, we have roads in, we have homes in, we have all of the property corners delineated already.
What can you say to someone who might say, well, you know, this went into effect or they made this announcement in 2012, even if they weren't consistently enforcing it, why not just follow the rule?
I think there's just so many unanswered questions that haven't been flushed out through the talks back and forth between the county approval process and what the post office is going to require themselves.
In the meantime, residents like the Korbas remain stuck in the middle of what they say feels like a cluster.
Figure it out, to make a decision. If it's a cluster box, so be it. Or deliver the mail here to my address, to my mailbox.
We asked a spokesperson for the U.S. Postal Service about the new Lake Margaret subdivision, as well as about the concerns raised by local builders and developers related to enforcement in the region. Now, the spokesperson did not answer our specific questions, but she did send us the following statement, quote, centralized delivery is the preferred mode for new or extended business or residential delivery points. Adding centralized delivery for new construction helps reduce costs and continue to affordably meet the needs of our customers. Working for you, I'm Melissa Hippolyte for CBS 6.
Wow, talk about frustrating. The CBS 6 problem solvers are here to help. Give us a call, 254-3672, or email problemsolvers@WTBR.com.